In 1957, two boys had an argument in a bowling alley in Whittier in California. They were called Kerry Thornley and Greg Hill. The argument was about the structure of the world. Kerry said that behind the chaos, there was an underlying order. Greg said that that was wrong. Order was just something that the human mind projected onto the chaos of reality. He persuaded Kerry that they should set up their own religion. The aim would be to show that you don't have to be enslaved to the reality of others. Instead, it would be a new kind of religion, one where there was no agreed story. Every person would make up their own beliefs to show that they were an individual, not controlled by society. They called it Discordianism. By 1969, Discordianism was beginning to take off across America. It was becoming an underground cult. While Kerry Thornley was now part of a group who edited Playboy magazine for Hugh Hefner. And they decided to use the magazine to start what they called Operation Mindfuck. The aim was to play with reality and reveal it to be the fabrication that it actually was. And the way to do this, they decided, was to push it to absurdity. They started by placing a fake letter in the Playboy edition of April 1969. The fake letter planted the seeds of a new conspiracy. It asked whether the wave of political assassinations in America were all being masterminded by a single secret society. And the society the letter named was the Illuminati. The Illuminati were a mysterious group that had been founded in the 18th century in Bavaria. Their original aim was to undermine the ruling religious order. Now, nearly 200 years later, the Illuminati, the letter said, were behind the chaos and horror sweeping through America. The letter was just the beginning. For the next 20 years, Operation Mindfuck spread underground through the counterculture in America and Europe. People inspired by Discordianism wrote letters, books, and even plays that blamed the Illuminati for everything. The aim was to use such an absurd idea to break through people's trust in the stories that they were told by the powerful and make them realize that the world was really just chaotic and made up. But then, in the 1990s, the confident stories told by those in power began to collapse of their own accord. And the strangest thing happened. More and more people began to believe that the absurd stories of Operation Mindfuck were actually true.
Oh, that clock. What a killjoy.
And the weirdest of all was the story that the Illuminati had conspired with Walt Disney and the CIA to create a powerful system of mind control. This system was now being used to control all the major stars, from Britney Spears to Beyoncé. The system was called MK Ultra.
Make that booty clap. 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 Make that booty.
Move it.
Make that booty.
Bang.
Make that booty.
Down.
Make that booty. Make that booty.
Move it.
Make that booty.
Bang.
Make that booty.
Down.
Make that booty. Make that booty.
Move it.
Make that booty.
Bang.
Make that booty.
Down.
Make that booty. Make that booty.
Move it.
Make that booty.
Bang.
Make that booty.
Down.
Make that booty. Make that booty.
Move it.
Make that booty.
Bang.
My own point of view, the most unexpected finding was to discover that a mild electrical current applied to the surface of the brain causes a patient to have a memory from his own past sometimes. And now...
The image of the human being that was being built up at that particular time was that there was a great deal of vulnerability in every human being, and that vulnerability could be manipulated to program somebody to be something that I wanted them to be and they didn't want to be. That you could manipulate people in such a way that they could be automatons, if you will, for whatever your own purposes were. This was the image that people thought was possible.
In 1973, the MK-Ultra experiments were shut down by the CIA. But in the years that followed, details of the attempts to brainwash the minds of human beings leaked out. And as they did so, they began to get mixed up with the stories put out by Operation Mindfuck, that the Illuminati were a hidden force behind much of Western society. And a strange story began to grow up, that not only were the CIA and the Illuminati involved in brainwashing pop stars, but that Walt Disney had also been involved, because he too was interested in controlling human beings.
It's a sort of another door that's opened for us in the world of making these human figures, dimensional human figures move, make animals move, make anything move, through the use of electronics. It's a tape mechanism that... The tape, it's like a programming or sequencing when they do a missile, when they're sending some missile to the moon, say. Yeah. At different stages, at different times, things must happen. That's all programmed, predetermined.
Oh, baby, how was I supposed? Baby, how was I supposed to know?
Conspiracy is an absurd myth of our time, but it has become very powerful. And maybe this is because people feel that it touches on a deeper truth about the modern world. They are told that they are free and independent individuals. But in today's confusion and distrust, they increasingly feel that there are other, powerful forces shaping their lives. And maybe they aren't really in control of their own destiny. The original aim of the MK-Ultra experiments was to find a way of wiping the human mind and then reconstructing it to create new and better kinds of human beings. But all the experiments were failures. They didn't really create new people. They just broke them down into simple, one-dimensional creatures. Strange automatons with no memories of the past and no vision of the future.
When I was discharged, I felt like an alien from another world visiting this world. I didn't fit. I was watching myself cooking, taking care of the children, doing the washing, but I knew I was different, and I didn't know how to become like everybody else. And it was a very lonely, scary place to be. People told me they were my children, but that didn't mean anything to me, so they were little people. They had names, and they smiled, and they went to school. It was, this is your husband. What's husband? What's making love? I don't know.
In the story of the Illuminati and the pop stars, there is a twist. The brainwashing doesn't work very well, and soon it begins to wear off.
Yeah.
Doug, what are you looking for, Brittany? Brittany, what are you looking for? Your what? Your memory card?
Shine the light on the
floor. Can someone look, find her memory card?
Perhaps in the real world today, we have also been simplified. We believe that our own self is at the center of the world, that we are the stars in our own stories. But maybe that dream is also beginning to wear off.
What about? What about feeling fear? 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 What about when you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you. If your heart is in your dream, no request is too extreme. When you wish upon a star, like dreamers do, fate is kind. She brings to those who love the sweet fulfillment of their secret longing. Like a bolt out of the blue, fate steps in and pulls you through. And you wish upon a star, your dream comes true.
Well done. It's too cool. Johan. Yeah.